Heroes will be made and dreams will come true in the next 2 weeks. Who's going to capture our imagination by becoming the Cinderella of this year's big dance? Dick and I will find out starting in today's game between the Oregon State Beavers and the Tennessee Volunteers.
Hey, Dad, the NCAA tournament is the reward. After a long season of practices, tough games, and all of those other rigors, the tournament is their pinnacle.
Dick, if you were coaching either one of these teams, what would your points of emphasis be?
First off, they may have a slight advantage when it comes down to rebound. They should send 4 or 5 guys to the offensive glass for some easy second chance opportunity. Next, they must get on their wing players and post players to run the floor. If they do so, their point guard will then be able to make the hit-ahead pass. Lastly, encourage your players to be overly aggressive at the defensive end. Really look for the steal or the trap.
Early in the ball game, these two teams try to set their particular tempo. They'll work it around the arc. They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works.
The center handles the pass. 10 seconds showing on the shot clock. Knocked it down. They've got him trapped here, Dick.
Look at that trap, Brad. Got numbers right here.
Isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc looking for the open jumper. 10 seconds to get it off. Great composure to pass it out of the trap. The shooting guard handles the pass. Takes the medium range jumper. Busts the jumper. Both teams looking to get things going here. For two. The layup. Dick, you got to be prepared when you go up against this team. They love to pressure the full court.
Hey, you've got that right, Mr. Nestler. They like to get in your face and force you to commit turnovers.
I tell you what, pressure. Look at them take the ball and lift to the court. No one stopped the basketball.
And there's a lazy pass. It's stolen away. Turnover. Will it turn into two the other way? Dick, you got to be prepared when you go up against this team. They love to pressure the full court.
Hey, you've got that right, Mr. Nestler. They like to get in your face and force you to commit turnovers.
Gave it up. They get it to go. Takes away the pass. That is a dagger in the heart, that shot, Dick.
Hey, they lost focus here. They need a timeout to regroup, Brad.
Let's check in with Erin Andrews and what she's got in store for us, Erin.
Coach has been quite animated over here on the sidelines. It's all positive, though. He's pleased with the manner in which they're playing their up-tempo style. I overheard him saying that if this continues, he likes his team's chances. Guys?
Thanks, EA, our third member of our team and our sideline reporter, keeping us up to date with what's taking place behind the scenes and around the bench. Good job, EA. Do you think they switch things around here for the moment, Dick?
I don't think so, but we'll wait and see, Brad.
Wide, wide open. Knocks down the two. Down the dribble, gives it up. Goes up for two. Up and in. Coach is trying to get the players to think defense now. Number 24 gets the ball. The skip pass is picked off. Well, whose team tempo will win out? That's the question right here, Dick.
You know, Brad, tempo is always important. Every team has their philosophy, and it's up to the players to follow the game plan.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Dick, you got to be prepared when you go up against this team. They love to pressure in the full court.
Hey, you've got that right, Mr. Nestler. They like to get in your face and force you to commit turnovers.
The shooting guard with the ball. They work the perimeter. He shoots from downtown. Tickles a twine. The Volunteers are cranking things up at the defensive end, and they're going to extend that pressure.
An aggressive move on their part, Brad. They'll be looking to force some turnovers.
Escapes the trouble and makes a pass out. They work it around the perimeter. For the bucket. Perfectly executed. The shooting guard receives the pass. They go with the entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper.
I tell you, what a nice turnaround jump shot. Soft as velvet, fading away, impossible to block.
Nice to have you along with us tonight. Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews alongside. I'm Brad Nestler. We got a good one going. Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot, and he did a great job. He anticipated that spin move.
Cross court. They get an open look for three. No good. Tries for two. Way off target. The lay-in. The Volunteers look like they want to use their defense to speed up this game.
You know, pressuring in the full court is a great tactic if you have the horses. Otherwise, it doesn't make much sense to play full court defense, Brad.
The point guard with the ball. Open shot. He's money from beyond the arc.
Up and inside.
Now looking to create with a ball screen.
Hey, the pick and roll is one play that so many teams use these days. A great way to buy a step for the dribbler.
Gets the feed down low. Now the turnaround jumper. The Volunteers have a hot hand right now that's scoring for them at the moment.
They need to keep feeding the ball. It's simple.
Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Coach has been pretty active over here on the sideline, providing some quality feedback to his players. I overheard him saying that he really likes the manner in which they've been playing. The up-tempo style is what they're known for and what they've been demonstrating so far. Don't look for that to change.
That's, of course, Aaron Andrews, our correspondent on the sideline. They look to get it to the inside for two. Can't get the shot to go. Trying to feed the low block. Now he faces up on the low block.
I think it's great when you got a post player that can face up on a defensive player and attack the basket.
A little two-man action. Outside jumper. Gets it to go. The Volunteers are looking, Dick, to force the tempo by extending their defense.
You know, forcing your opponent to play in the full court is a great idea if you have the athleticism to play that style, Brad. Otherwise, you may not be very successful pressuring in the full court.
The point guard gets the pass. Goes up for two. Up and in. And there's what the game tempo is looking like tonight.
Two teams are picking and choosing when they want to push the ball, Brad. Had a little trap really well there, Brad.
The center receives the pass. With a little baby hook, he takes the board. Number 15 is whistled for the defensive foul. All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Brad, before the game, the coaches told us their only worry was their team getting down too early. Now that this team has, the players are trying very hard not to panic and put it all together.
Thanks, Aaron. EA, of course, our third member, getting that additional insight and dealings from the sideline.
Oh, he drained it. That's on the nylon, MBN.
Timeout. I'm pretty sure you're going to agree with this, Dick. The best coaches always seem to have their teams prepared coming out of a timeout.
Preparation's the name of the game, Brad. You have to be prepared at the start of games and following timeouts. Failing to have a plan at these points during the game is ill-advised.
We get ready to bounce back into action here. The center gets the ball. Gave it up. The layup.
I'll tell you, I can't understand defensively how guys don't see the ball in man. That was just simply a case of not seeing ball man.
The small forward with the ball. Cross court. They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works.
The Volunteers are really looking to turn up the pressure and the overall game tempo with this press, Dick.
I tell you, it looks like they want the tempo to be at the higher end of the spectrum. This will definitely impact the pace.
With a bucket, up and in. The ball goes out of play. This man's in trouble.
He almost found himself in some trouble there, Brad.
They're working around the perimeter. Tries for two.
The layup.
The center takes the pass. For two, in and out. Number 34 with the ball. Looking to move it around the perimeter. Goes up for two. You gotta control yourself. That suit's got to be feeling pretty hot about now. Things are not going well.
Wow, look at the dejection, the disappointment, the depression, the three D's.
He goes to the line for the first time. First one is no good. Misses the second shot. The shooting guard handles the pass. For the bucket. Yikes, misses the easy one. 5-second call approaching. Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot, and he did a great job. He anticipated that spin move.
And he's going to pick up the foul, and oh, look at the look on his face.
I'll tell you what, he's disgusted, but so is his coach.
Tries for two, perfectly executed. Check out the replay, Dick. Definitely worth being part of our Pontiac game-changing performance.
Talk about highlight material, Mr. Nestler. That's a strong candidate for our Pontiac game-changing performance.
Look at that spacing.
That was really a nonchalant pass. Get that sucker out of the game, man.
Up and in. Pushes it up.
Slam jam bam, up and away, the elevator man, they love it.
Both teams are looking to get something going here. On the dribble, gives it up. He looks for the bomb. Nope. On the outside, pull-up jumper, left side, the missed shot, pushes it up, now coming down with numbers, number 20, he took it hard to the rack and got the foul.
Well, that's what his coach likes to see, his boys going hard to the hole and not settling for the jump shot.
Dick, we all know how important it is to get to the free throw line.
Well, there's no doubt about it. I think it's such an unbelievable plus. It means you're playing aggressive basketball, you're playing attacking basketball, and you're creating all kinds of foul problems for the opponent.
Trying to execute on the inbounds.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. For two, perfectly executed.
Here's one for the highlight reel.
Cross court. They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside outside action always works.
He fades away, and they don't score there either. The shooting guard receives the pass. And he goes with a spin.
I tell you, feel the defensive player on your hip. Going one way, you spin back the other way.
Nobody seems to know where to go on defense, Dick.
They've got to talk this one over.
With the J. A lot of people can't hit that shot anymore, Dick. That 10-12-foot shot.
Yeah, the medium-range shot is an extension.
Eludes the trap there. The shooting guard takes the pass. Goes up for two. The layup.
Up and inside. Oh, what a high rise. A great vision. The fans love it. What a terrific play.
with a bucket.
Up and in.
Number five takes the feed. He tries the jumper. The Volunteers have got to continue to get him the ball.
Daddy's on fire.
Nick, you got to be prepared when you go up against this team. They love to pressure in a full court.
Hey, you've got that right, Mr. Nestler. They like to get in your face and force you to commit turnovers.
The point guard with the ball. Tries for two. Perfectly executed. Number 32 gets the ball. That spin move's not going to work against a defense like that.
I tell you, they did a great job scouting post-play because they were really anticipating the spin.
Let's check in courtside with Aaron Andrews. Aaron?
Brad, some of the players told me before the game they felt their biggest key was to get the ball inside. They said, we have the personnel to score in the paint, and that's what makes us a big threat.
All right, Aaron, we're going to watch that the rest of the game.
I'll tell you one thing, she's essentially right. Down in the post is where you create a lot of offensive action.
For two, they're absolutely owning the boards tonight, Dick.
And if you own the boards, you own the game.
Goes up for two. The lay-in. Dick, you got to be prepared when you go up against this team. They love to pressure in the full court.
Hey, you've got that right, Mr. Nestler. They like to get in your face and force you to commit turnovers.
For the bucket. Up and in. Pushes it up. Tries for two. The lay-in. The Volunteers are really looking to turn up the pressure and the overall game tempo with this press, Dick.
I tell you, it looks like they want the tempo to be at the higher end of the spectrum. This will definitely impact the pace.
And a momentary look from three-point land. Spin move's not going to work against a defense like that.
I tell you, they did a great job scouting post-play because they were really anticipating the spin.
For two, number 12 is whistled for the foul. Fourth team foul. He'll go to the line. Makes the first shot. Doesn't miss that opportunity either. They are nailing the free ones tonight, Mr. Vitale.
Hey, this is where you win and lose games, Brad.
Well, this man's in trouble. Eludes the trap there. He's clearly forcing things right now, Dick.
He's taking his team out of the game.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
He shoots from right of the circle.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
Number five handles the pass. Looking for a good shot. Goes up for two. Up and in. Gave it up. With the catch. Nice execution on the spin.
I tell you, great spin move to the basket.
The man might be in a little bit of trouble here, Dick. Pushes it up. for the bucket. The layup. Pushes it up. Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
Number one gets the ball. He gets the board. Puts up a prayer. That was nice. At halftime, the Beavers are down by 24. We've really been on a roller coaster here tonight, Dick. Any highlights of the half for our viewers?
Watch this dunk right here. This is a clear indication of what we can expect from both teams in the second half. They're both going to come out hard.
We're about ready to start the second half, Dick. Let's go down and see how this one unfolds. Tennessee had an awesome first half shooting the ball, Dick. Can we expect more of that in the second half, you think?
Hey, with the composure they're showing on the floor, Brad, I wouldn't doubt it. This is a very methodical team.
Sideline inbounds. Let's check in with Erin Andrews and what she's got in store for us, Erin.
Well, Brad and Dick, as we know, this is it. Now, I can hear from both teams' huddles the excitement. They are ready to play and leave it all out on the floor. This is going to be an exciting second half.
All right, thanks, Erin.
I'll tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on the box.
He's money with the shot. Can their defense get him back in the game, Dick?
I tell you, it's going to be a long hike back, Brad.
On the outside. The man asking for a screen here.
Hey, whether it ends up in a roll or fade, it's well-executed two-man game is always a treat to watch.
Moving it around the perimeter. Goes up. 10 on the shot clock. Kicks it out. Has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
On the dribble, gives it up. For two, with a layup. Number 23 takes the pass. Kicks it out. Here comes the ball screen. He's called for charging.
What toughness.
That one puts the personal in personal. Picks up the foul.
I tell you, poor play defensively. Look at the facial expression.
They've got him right where they want him, Dick. He passes it out of the trap. They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, they're really doing a great job packing it in and a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Tries for two. Up and in. The small forward receives the ball. Kicks it out. That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot.
Cross court. He rejects it. 10 seconds left on the shot clock. There's a look at the current tempo for the game.
That stat doesn't surprise me, Brad. The pace of the game has been pretty slow.
He passes it out of the trap.
Great pass out of the trap, Brad.
The point guard gets the ball. They get an open three. He gets it to fall. Cross court. Goes up for two. The layup. The Volunteers are really looking to turn up the pressure and the overall game tempo with this press, Dick.
I tell you, it looks like they want the tempo to be at the higher end of the spectrum. This will definitely impact the pace.
Number 34 receives the ball. Looking for a good shot. 10 seconds showing on the shot clock. For two, doesn't go. Lays it up. They've got to figure out a way to slow him down.
I'd start to get physical with him and I'd see what happens.
You start comparing these backcourts, Dick. What are your impressions so far?
You know what, for me, Brad, good guard play will take you a long way. If you think about teams in the past, they all had good guards who can apply good ball pressure, attack off the dribble, and distribute the ball. I can't emphasize enough how important backcourt play is.
He goes to the line for the first time. Makes his first. They have found their stroke at the stripe tonight, Dick.
This has always been an excellent free throw shooting bunch.
Gets the second shot. They're shooting extremely well from the stripe tonight, Dick.
Yeah, they're making their coaches look good for making them shoot extra free throws every day. Great composure to pass it despite the trap, Brad.
The point guard takes the feed. The ball goes out of bounds. Oh, that's going to be a costly turnover, Dick.
I'll tell you, turnovers can absolutely destroy a team.
The shooting guard gets the ball. Goes up for two. Up and in. Ten seconds are up there.
They got to move the ball up, Brad.
Boy, assist to turnover ratios are big, and that's a big turnover.
I tell you, they're turning the ball over too often. You can't win when you do that.
Working it around the perimeter. 3 second violation.
Better watch your feet.
Now they work it around the perimeter. Student body, they are going mad.
They want to win just as bad as anyone else in the building.
Overplays on the pass, and he didn't get the steal.
Oh, he's humiliated. Poor job defensively.
Escapes the trouble and makes a pass out. They'll work it around the arc. They're going to call that a backcourt violation.
Somebody got a little nervous that time, Brad.
Isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc, looking for the open jumper.
Hey, dodge one there, Brad.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing's so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Picks off the lazy pass. Now trying to feed the low block. 10 on the shot clock. Great composure to pass it out of the trap. Refs call the foul the other way.
That's how you take a charge, baby.
Oh, and he's not going to be happy with that call.
Well, silly foul right there, but look at his face. His facial expression tells it all.
The small forward receives the pass. For the bucket. They are red hot right now.
They're feeling it from everybody on the floor, Brad. They're getting it from every spot on the court.
Dick, you got to be prepared when you go up against this team. They love to pressure in the full court.
Hey, you've got that right, Mr. Nestler. They like to get in your face and force you to commit turnovers.
Dumps it in. Tries for two. The layup. The small forward takes the pass. They work the perimeter. The entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper.
Good rebound position. Once you get that board, you've got to be looking up court.
They go into the low block. That spin move's not going to work against a defense like that.
I tell you, they did a great job scouting post play because they were really anticipating the spin.
I think he was there, Dick.
Yeah, but that could have gone either way.
And he's going to pick up the foul, and oh, look at the look on his face.
I'll tell you what, he's disgusted, but so is his coach.
Traps in place, Dick. Eludes the trap there. Working around the perimeter. You can't get away with that. Let's go to the third member of our broadcast team. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, the crowd certainly hope for a closer matchup. One side of the arena is celebrating in the stands, and the other one is just sitting there in complete disbelief, guys.
Thanks, Aaron. The point guard gets the pass.
Dump it inside.
In the clear. Sticks the deuce.
Hey, don't let these guys get in too much of a rhythm.
Can they regroup in time, you think?
Let's see what happens.
He shoots from the top of the circle, and it's no good from three-point range. The point guard handles the pass. They work it around the perimeter. Ten seconds showing on the shot clock. Nice defensive rebound. They clear it ahead in transition.
As soon as you get that defensive rebound, you should be looking to push the ball.
For two, he doesn't get the hoop. Looking to move it around the perimeter. Goes up for two. Not this time. Gave it up. He shoots from long range. Not a great decision there to shoot the ball.
That shot was definitely ill-advised. Look at that spacing.
That spin move not successful, Dick.
I did a great job on the defense, not allowing him to make that turn.
The Beavers have found a player who cannot seem to miss, Dick.
They need to keep feeding him the ball. It's simple.
The shooting guard takes the pass. On the outside, he's all alone. You can't go those kind of stretches against a team of this quality and expect to win. For the bucket, up and in.
Number three, 4-2.
They'll take a timeout right here. Well, let's see now if they've gotten everything sorted out during that last timeout.
Yes, it's time to see just how focused the team is. In a situation like this, it's all up to the five on the floor to carry out the game plan and play together at both ends of the floor.
It's always interesting to see who's still hot and who's not after a timeout, Dick.
Well, you gotta think, the shooters might be the most effective, Brad.
Jumped in front to take it away. The small forward with the ball. On the dribble, gives it up. Ten seconds left on the shot clock. Strong rebound.
Fill the lanes. That's the only way they'll be able to get some fast break opportunities.
Tries for two. The lane. There's sort of a snapshot of our game tempo.
These teams are selectively pushing the ball and looking for transition opportunities.
He hits the tough shot.
I'll tell you, he's not going down with ease, Brad.
Cross court. Ten on the shot clock. Gets the feed down low. Now the turnaround jumper. Pulls it down.
Getting that quick outlet pass is so important for the fast break.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. He dials long distance. Not a wise decision to take that shot there.
I don't think the coach wants him taking that shot.
Up and in. Dick, you got to be prepared when you go up against this team. They love to pressure in the full court.
Hey, you've got that right, Mr. Nestler. They like to get in your face and force you to commit turnovers.
Great composure to pass it out of the trap. Number 15 gets the ball. Gave it up. Tries the turn and the defense comes up with a play.
What a terrific.
The shot drops and the foul.
Great concentration on the shot, Brad.
Well, Mr. Vitale, I know you like bench productivity. What are your thoughts so far on this one?
Hey, Brad, I'll tell you one thing. You're only as good as your 12th guy. Almost always holds true to that statement. Well, your bench play plays an important role in games, but also in practices where they're expected to push the starters. Competitive practices will result in better game performances.
And the better game performances should result in more wins. Dick, you got to be prepared when you go up against this team. They love to pressure in a full court.
Hey, you've got that right, Mr. Nestler. They like to get in your face and force you to commit turnovers.
Number 30 takes the pass.
Up and inside.
Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
The Volunteers want to up the pressure here, Dick, and I think they're going to change the tempo of the game with their defense.
You know, it's a great decision, Brad, if you have the right personnel to play full court defense.
I say they all want to take it to the rack. High wire rack, baby. Little tipsy Zoo Dunkaroo.
And a momentary look from three-point land. Steals the pass. The center handles the pass. Tries for two. Sweet looking shot.
He is super. He really is.
He gets the rejection. Number 30 is seemingly at an emotional low right now.
Emotionally, he needs some inspiration.
He bombs from outside. He gets the bucket to fall. The Volunteers are really looking to turn up the pressure and the overall game tempo with this press, Dick.
I'll tell you, it looks like they want the tempo to be at the higher end of the spectrum. This will definitely impact the pace.
On the dribble, gives it up. Whistled for the foul. How important is it to get to the free throw line?
Well, you know, those bonus points, Brad, you get those simple points. They add up at the end. Plus, you get people into foul trouble.
And he got them both. No problem so far at the free throw line tonight, Dick.
Well, they're making the most of the free ones.
The Beavers like to play a half-court style, Dick. What types of players do they usually attract to their program?
They sure do, Brad. They operate in a manner which is very strategic. They run sets and often shoot the ball late in the possession.
Number three comes up with it. The shooting guard with the ball. Fed the low block. Now the turnaround jumper.
Nothing but nylon. Nice, smooth turnaround jumper. The only negative, he's falling away. If he misses, he's got no rebound in the building.
Escape the trap.
Passes it out of the trap.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
How about this State Farm moment, brought to us from our good friends at State Farm. Kicks it out. He's all alone. And he makes the three. As we continue to track the game's tempo.
We've seen a combination of both short and long possessions here, Black. Nothing wrong with that if that's your team's ideal style of play.
Looking for a good shot. He fouled him. And he's going to pick up the foul, and oh, look at the look on his face.
I'll tell you what, he's disgusted, but so is his coach.
I tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on a box.
Tons of room. He can't miss.
Hey, this young man's feeling it, Brad.
The center handles the feed. Goes up for two. Sweet looking shot.
He is super. He really is.
Dick, you got to be prepared when you go up against this team. They love to pressure the full court.
Hey, you've got that right, Mr. Nestler. They like to get in your face and force you to commit turnovers.
bucket. And off the mark. The shooting guard with the ball. Tries for two. Number 32 picks up the defensive foul. Second personal foul.
I think it's important to get to the free throw line, Brad. It demonstrates that you're playing aggressively and that you're not settling for the jumper.
Second shot, good. As we see the game situation here.
Hey, Brad, these are elements of the game which coaches are really responsible for. Calling timeouts at the right time, knowing which way the possession arrow is pointing. All factors that are important in close games.
He passes it out of the trap. Gave it up. Everyone on that bench thrilled and excited over there.
It looks like someone has lit a fire under that bench, man.
Ball's coming from the sideline.
If you want to know how aggressive a team is, you check to see how many times they go to the free throw line. That's a great indicator.
No doubt. Nick, they're really getting it done from the line tonight, aren't they?
And a surprisingly collective effort, Brad.
The Volunteers are cranking things up at the defensive end, and they're going to extend that pressure.
An aggressive move on their part, Brad. They'll be looking to force some turnovers.
It out of the trap. Number 15 gets the ball. I think the coach is going to have to make some changes here, Dick. The players are starting to look really tired out there. He fires from long range. No good from the field. The small forward with the ball. Another one's in the books. Any final thoughts about the keys we had coming into this game?
Well, I look at those as suggestions and clues which should help a team get the W. Obviously, the more check marks, the better. I get concerned when a team completely neglects the points of emphasis and plays completely out of style.
Every game's unique, and in every game, it's up to the players to control the tempo and their team's ideal style of play. You do it consistently, you're going to win more games. Seems simple to me. Dick, I think we saw a good tournament game. Both teams played pretty well, and, you know, I feel bad for the team that's got to go home.
Well, the better team won because they protected the basketball. They made sure they converted on the free throw line. They did all the little intangibles we talked about, and that was the difference in the game.
The Volunteers came, they saw, and they conquered their first-round foe, Dick.
I tell you, Brad, watch out for this team because the coach has these kids playing with more intensity than they ever did during a regular season. And I'm going to tell you, it's going to serve them well as now they shift into gear for that second-round matchup.
It's been a fun game, and as always, my partners alongside have enjoyed you being with us. For Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler. Good night, everybody.